11 rzeczy w Eldenie, które należy zrobić pierwszych.
Elden Ring boasts a huge variety of secrets, deep gameplay elements, and punishing lessons for those who don't take it seriously.
No.
And while the joy of discovery is a major draw in From Software's newest adventure, a little bit of help in the beginning can save a lot of headaches in the future. Here are 11 things to do first in Elden Ring.
No, na przykład co jest pierwszą rzeczą? Pierwsza rzecz, stwórz postać, druga rzecz, znajdź Melinę i Torrenta.
One of the new additions to Elden Ring from the Souls games is the ability to craft special items, such as fire pots, arrows, and even healing items for your horse.
No.
Upon activating the first sight of grace when stepping out into Limgrave, follow the golden thread to this point, the Church of Ella. Here you'll find a merchant
Dobra
that will
rada.
Sell you the crafting kit, and
Dobra
another
rada.
Necessary item, the torch. You only need 500 runes to
ta pochodnia to
so
nie jest potrzebna specjalnie, ale dobra.
We'll provide plenty of soldiers to farm until you have enough.
Jest okej na razie, no.
After visiting the Church of Ella, follow along the nearby road through the trees.
Znajdź Melinę,
once again,
miałem rację.
And you'll run headfirst into these ruins where you'll find a bunch of enemies. Go around them on the left side for now and head to this location.
Ja
right
przez pierwsze 50 godzin nie wiedziałem, że można craftować itemy. Ja przez pierwsze 100 na Godskin Duo się dowiedziałem, że można i tak tego nie zrobiłem ostatecznie.
This side of Grace or whichever third grace you touch will introduce you to Melina, an important NPC that will let you spend your runes to level up. Melina will also give you the ability to summon Torrent, your spirit horse that will be your main method of
Dobra
transportation
rada.
Across the lands between.
Zobaczmy, co jest trzecim krokiem.
After getting Torrent, fast
nie!
travel back to the Church of Ella where you met Merchant Santa. And across the courtyard, you'll find a witch who gives you a summoning bell.
Nie!
This bell allows you to summon spirits to aid you in area.
IGN! Nie!
It's when this white arched logo appears in the left middle part of the
Nie!
Screen. These spirits cost FP, your magic meter, in order to summon, and are separate from story NPCs or co-op partners that you summon in ways similar
Nie!
To the other Souls games. When you first open your map, you'll notice that important locations and sites of grace are marked, but the rest is covered in a brown fog.
Dobra, i ty chcesz mi powiedzieć, że mam wziąć Samona przed mapą? Ugh!
You'll need map fragments for each area to expose the topography, and they can be found at the base of pillars that look like this.
No tak, bo zdobycie mapy może być trudnym zadaniem. Są przeciwnicy, to trzeba co nieco wilczków tutaj przyzywać.
First one is in the aforementioned bandit camp, which is just had to circumvent, right next to the storm gate. Fight or sneak your way into the center along the road and grab the fragment to make the surrounding area a little more clear.
A nie, no zakradł się.
If you're feeling daring, in the same ruins of
Dobra,
the bandits,
znajdź osełkę, powiem tak, ja pierwszy raz ją znalazłem dopiero teraz. Ja w tych ruinach pierwszy raz wlazłem pod siebie na nohicie.
Underground tunnel that leads to some ashes of war and the whetstone knife, which allows you to freely change out your ashes of war among your weapons.
Co osełka robi? Może zmieniać ash of war przy ognisku, nie musisz tepać do round table.
Distinct abilities that can be switched out at sites of grace to suit your playstyle, and they affect stats and stat scaling on the weapons you use. Whatever stat you're building your character for, be it strength, dexterity, or even faith, having a weapon that scales exponentially with that stat will pay major dividends in the long run. If you're looking for more Ashes of War, they can be found here, at the Warmaster Shack directly north from Gatefront. Head northwest through Storm
to ja miałem osełkę i latałem do Round Table, no widzisz no, bo taki odruch jest no.
The Storm Hill Shack, pop in real quick for reasons we'll make clear later, and then head east for the easiest way to get there. Although there may be one or two obstacles on your way. If you're looking for a fun introduction to various systems, mechanics, and the kinds of surprises Elden Ring has to offer, look no farther than Murkwater Cave, resting alongside the bed of the river here in Limgrave. Move alongside the river's west side going south until you pass the bridge.
Dobra, Murkwater Cave to jest dobra rada akurat. Patrzę, nie jest złą radą. Ale coś czuję, że będą kajdany Margita brane od tego.
The river, and look for a fire guiding the entrance on the left side. Keep your head on a swivel and be ready to defend yourself from an unusual attacker. Just in case.
Zobaczmy.
While there are several giant dungeons in Elden Ring that you can't miss, there are tons of little dungeons peppered throughout the lands between that offer anything from optional boss fights or even the fun little misadventures like the one at Murkwater Cave. A lot of these can be found in underground tunnels in the center of ruins, but there are other
Nawet nie
ones
powiedzieli,
well.
Że masz tam najazd? A wiecie czemu? Bo jestem przekonany, że osoba, która robiła ten film, po prostu sama nie dała rady. Oni nawet nie powiedzieli dokładnie, po co ci ta jaskinia, w zasadzie. On po prostu stwierdził, polecę im pójść do jaskini.
Out and not just moving along the path of the golden thread. Every class in Elden Ring starts with their own weapon, and while a lot of these are more than adequate for a good long while, you'll better serve your playthrough by finding better ones to invest in with Ashes of War and upgrades from the blacksmith.
To prawda.
One of these weapons could be found at the Murkwater Cave we mentioned earlier if you're focusing on a deck.
No, chłop tarczu używa.
Build. And there are two in the Gatefront Ruins right by the site of Grace where you first met Melina. Just check these giant stone caves.
Najlepsze jest to, że ja się śmieję, a przecież to jest mechanika gry, masz prawo. Tak samo z samonami. Żeby nie było, to jest pod bekę, nie? Jak chcesz, to używaj. A po prostu dziwnie wygląda, jak ktoś przyjmuje atak na tarczę i nie roluje go. To jest takie nienaturalne dla mnie. Mimo, że wygląda bardziej naturalnie.
Carriages to pick up both the flail and the Lord Sworn's greatsword. You can upgrade your weapons all the way to +3 at the anvil at the Church of Ella, but in order to do that, you'll need smithing stones.
Nice.
You can find these strewn about the opening areas, but one of the best places to pick them up is in the Limgrave.
Tarcze bez parowania są useless, Imo? Nie no, ale ty, czy to nie jest tak, że jest na tarczy coś takiego, że przytrzymujesz tarczę i masz wtedy jakiś super mocny cios po tarczy? Jak dostaniesz hita na tarczę, to możesz zrobić takiego fzzz! Takiego mocniejszego i on jest całkiem niezły akurat.
On the north side of the lake, next to your starting area. Just be aware that crossing the lake means you may encounter certain obstacles.
Ej, wejście Akhila na mapę jest zarąbiste akurat. Mów co chcesz.
Remember those spirits we talked about earlier? They can be...
Podoba mi się, że chłop przeszedł połowę Limgrave, zanim zebrał flail. On tak, poszedł do ogniska obok ruin, cofnął się po samony, których i tak używasz tylko na bosie, potem wrócił do tych ruin, wziął mapę, potem poszedł z nich, wziął coś innego, potem poszedł po osełkę, potem poszedł gdzieś indziej, a potem znowu wrócił po flaila. Po co se ogarnąć za jednym zamachem całe ruiny, nie?
Useful for crowd control, distracting a boss.
Drużyna pierścienia.
Remember those spirits we talked about?
Three Sentinel nie wie co się dzieje.
Incredibly useful for crowd control, distracting a boss, or actually doing decent damage. But you have to find them first.
I teraz największy wstyd, do jakiego muszę się przyznać. Margita i Three Sentinela zabiłem z wilkami za pierwszym razem.
To just give you a heads up for a few of them, the Wandering Noble Ashes are in the Stormfoot Catacombs northwest of the first steps. The Godric Soldier Ashes are here in Stormhill Cemetery, surrounded by jellyfish enemies outside the castle on the far left cliffs. And you can get the actual jellyfish spirit from a woman in this shack in Stormhill we mentioned earlier. And that's it. Our next tip was going to be die 17 times until you get that boss's pattern down just right, but we
17? Ja na Godricku umarłem 120 razy. Nie żartuję. Elden Ring Review. Dali temu 9 czy 10? Uff, macie szczęście, nie?